We are at the Indian Navy's Nodal Center, IMAC. Captain Bahuguna, if you can explain to us what we see here and in relation to Operation Sankalp.
At this center, primarily what we do is we collate the overall maritime picture for the Indian Ocean region. We get inputs from various sources, collate that over here, develop a comprehensive operational picture, and this then is disseminated to all the subsidiary nodes along the network and various stations along the coastline.
So what we are seeing here are what's called white shipping, merchant ships, right?
That's right. That's right. What we see on the screen presently in front of you, that is primarily the white shipping information. Added to that, a lot of other organic sensors from which we collect the information. Each of the blocks that you can see on the screen in front represents a ship, and each of that ship, once we, with the help of the software, we can pull out its details, various attributes, and analyze the same. The people who are sitting right in front, these are our operators who are carrying 24/7 watchkeeping and monitoring this entire area, this entire region. However, presently the focus, as you rightly said, is on Operation Sankalp, and therefore I would like to zoom into the Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman region.
Well, all the blue squares are, the dark navy blue squares are Indian ships, right? Indian flagged ships.
That is correct. In the Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman region, we can see roughly about 32 to 35 ships which are presently there. As you are aware that in view of the recent incidents in the Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman region, the Indian Navy has executed Operation Sankalp.
Right.
And as part of Operation Sankalp, the Indian Navy has deployed two ships, that is Indian Naval Ship Chennai and Indian Naval Ship Sunaina.
They are on both sides of the Gulf of Oman. Where are they placed?
You are right. Presently, Sunaina is in this area and Chennai is in this area. And the crucial area where the traffic separation scheme runs is somewhere from the Persian Gulf. This is the Strait of Hormuz and this side up to the Gulf of Oman. So this is the area primarily in which we are looking at supporting our ships. Now, the Indian Navy has primarily launched Operation Sankalp so as to increase the confidence amongst the Indian merchant marine which are transiting through this region, and this center is supporting the endeavor of the Indian Navy by closely monitoring all the Indian flagged ships which are transiting through this area. We are keeping a real-time stock of the situation, not only of the Indian ships but also shipping of the other countries.
When you're talking about that, the Operation Sankalp, if you can explain a little bit more in terms of how the MARC forces operate, and again, I presume this is a voluntary, the ships or the companies have to approach the Navy for this kind of protection?
You're right. In the present maritime security operations that are being undertaken by the Indian Navy, the Indian ships embark armed support team on each of these ships. Now that is inserted with the help of a boat. The boat generally goes around the ship to be embarked.
Surveys
for any physical attachments, etc., to see to it that everything is safe. Thereafter, it embarks. The team comprises of armed naval personnel, and thereafter they provide the support in transiting through this area.
This inverted V.
The team primarily embarks in this area, which is generally you can see an inverted V area. So they are embark from this side and disembark this side, or they embark from this side and disembark them on the other side. Now, as on date, we have completed about 10 such operations. 10 such ships have been embarked by the Indian Navy. In fact, the last ship has been embarked just about a couple of hours back, and In fact, one of the ships, which you can just see the highlighted one, you can see the details in the tote over there. This ship is Sabarimala Gas. This was embarked yesterday by the Indian Navy, and presently, as you can see, it is doing a course 115. That means it is exiting this area and heading towards, heading out of the Gulf of Oman. We can just pull out the details of the ship from our database also, and we can see all the details. All these details are also being provided by us to our concerned directorates and to the ships which are actually deployed in the area.
If you can explain why this region is so important, you have data to show how many ships, Indian flagged ships, are operating, say, in the month of July in that region?
In fact, that's a pertinent question. If you can just see on the screen, which is farther to the left, you can see that in the month of June itself, in the last 24 days, about 4,900 ships of different nationalities have transited this area of Persian Gulf and Gulf of Oman. And a country-wise breakdown is, now as can be seen on the screen, India accounts for about 2 to 3% of the ships which are transiting this area. If we go into the Indian ships which have been transiting this area in the month of June, we can see that about 100 ships, 99 Indian ships, have transited this area in the last 24 days. On an average, if you see, about 25 to 30 Indian ships are transiting this hotspot area presently. If you go into the breakdown of these ships, we find that almost 73% of the Indian ships in this region
are tankers.
So that clearly brings out the criticality of the merchant traffic which is transiting this area.
Can you also just explain how significant Operation Sankalp is in terms of its actually the first time this is happening? Indian ships may have escorted and done anti-piracy operations in the Gulf of Aden before, may have escorted bulk carriers, ULCCs, VLCCs, but this is the first time that MARC was actually boarding ships and helping them transit and if there's any trouble.
I would say that Indian Navy has been prompt to respond to such situations in the region always. However, in the current situation that we are in, the Indian Navy has, yes, it is a unique operation in which we have been promptly providing support to all the Indian merchant marine which is transiting through this region. And the presence of Indian naval ships in this area not only safeguards the Indian marine, but also sends a very, very
strong message
to all other shipping fraternity which is present in the region.
And in that region itself, India has a lot of various ports that these two ships, Sunaina and Chennai, can dock in terms of refueling, operational turnaround.
I must share with you that the ships have been deployed there for quite some time now, and both the ships, incidentally, in a staggered manner, would be going on for a very quick operational turnaround in the ports in UAE and Oman, and within a day, both would be resuming their operations once again to support the security operations of escorting our own merchant marine in this region.
Captain Bahuguna, thank you so much for sharing this information with us.
Pleasure.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you, sir.